Hey there, and welcome to this video. Today I will talk about gradients with respect to inputs, and I will give you two examples of how you can use them. The first one is adversarial attacks. The goal is to fool a pre-trained network to change its prediction by modifying the input features. And the second example is going to be about trying to explain predictions of a pre-trained neural network. Before I start, let me just give a quick shout out to the more notorious gradients, and that is the gradients with respect to the parameters, which you can see on the right. They are used heavily during the training process of neural networks because it is with their help that we can update the trainable parameters. Anyway, let's get started. All right, the first example is going to be using an algorithm called the fast gradient sign method. I believe it was first introduced in this paper, Explaining and Harnessing Adversarial Examples, written by Ian Goodfellow and other authors in 2015. I'm not going to describe this paper in detail, and instead I'm just going to show you the place where they propose the algorithm. First of all, the figure is really instructive. The setup is the following. We start with an image of a panda. As you can see, the classifier is able to correctly predict that it is indeed a panda. Our goal is then to find a small perturbation of the image that will fool the classifier network. Funnily enough, the small perturbation might not even be visible to the human eye. So how do we come up with this perturbation? Well, it is nothing else than the gradient with respect to the input. However, we are only interested in its sign. Since we add this perturbation to the original image, we are hoping to increase the classification loss. Also note that we multiplied the perturbation image by a small epsilon to make sure that the change is minimal. All right, let us first create a couple of utility functions. Alright, we are using Pillow to deal with images, we are using Torch to do deep learning related things, and finally we are using Torch Vision Transforms to pre-process our images. Let us start with the star of the show, which is a function that computes the gradient with respect to inputs. The first argument of this function is a callable, and it should define how we get from the input to a final number representing, let's say, the loss. The second argument is going to be our input tensor. And finally, we have keyword arguments that we can pass to our func callable. What our function returns is the gradient, and it has exactly the same shape as the input. Here we are assuming that our input tensor is a leave node, and by setting requires grad equal to true, we are telling Torch to compute the gradient with respect to this tensor. We take our input tensor and we run it through the func callable. What it could represent, for example, is a forward pass over neural network followed by some loss criterion. Here we tell Torch to compute the gradients. And finally, we just undo what we did as a first step of this function. This function then returns the actual gradient tensor. As you would probably agree, this function is extremely simple, yet it does all the hard work. Let me now define a couple of boilerplate utility functions that we will use in both of our examples. Goal of this function is to take an image that is lying somewhere on our disk and convert it to a tensor that we can right away use with pre-trained networks. The composite transform contains the following steps. First of all, we resize our image to be a square, and then we crop a smaller square in the center. We then convert the image to a Torch tensor, and finally we normalize. Note that these means and standard deviations are available in the documentation of Torch Vision, and I guess they were just computed from the training set of ImageNet. We transform the image, and then we add an extra dimension to the front of it, representing the batch dimension, and we return it. So this function will take an input tensor, it will undo the normalization that we did in the previous function, and it will turn it into a NumPy array that we can use in matplotlib right away. We remove the batch dimension. This transform is supposed to undo the normalization we did in the readImage function. We run the transform and then we permute the dimensions in order for the channels to be the last dimension, and then just return it. Right, this function is motivated by the fact that gradients can have any values whatsoever. And our goal is to take a gradient tensor and turn it into a tensor that has elements in the range of 0 and 1. This heuristic can help us visualize the magnitude of the gradient in different parts of the image. We first compute the absolute values, then we take an average over the channel dimension, and finally we put the channel dimension to the very end. Here we divide all the elements of the tensor by a number that is very close to the maximum, but it's not quite the maximum. Here I chose the 98th quantile, but you can play around with this. Here we make sure that all the elements are in the range 0, 1. And finally, we turn it into a NumPy array and return. All right, let us now move to the actual example. As you can see, I imported Torch Vision models in order to be able to load a pre-trained model. I'm also going to import some of the utility functions we just implemented. We will pass this function to the compute gradient utility. It will compute the negative log likelihood loss for a given input image and a given target. We run the forward pass, and then we compute the loss. We print its value and return it. And now we're ready to write the attack function. Alright, the first argument is a tensor which represents the input image. The second argument is our pre-trained classifier network. Epsilon will control the size of the perturbation. Number of iterations represents the maximum number of iterations we run the attack for. What this function returns is a new image that is going to be hopefully as similar to the input as possible. However, the predicted label is going to be different. First of all, we clone the input tensor so that we are not modifying it in place. We check what the original prediction is on the input image. And now we move to the main for loop. First of all, we make sure that all the gradients are set to zero. We We use our utility function computeGradient to get the gradient with respect to the input. Know that the target here is going to be the original prediction. This line represents the core of this attack. We compute the sine of our gradient, multiply it by a small number, and then we add it to the current image. We also clamp this image into the range of -2 and 2 in order to make sure that the image stays realistic. We take our new image and we let the network classify it. If the new prediction is different than the original prediction, we manage to fool the network and our attack is over. Finally, we just return the new image, the original prediction, and the new prediction. Let me just stress that the idea of the algorithm is to move in the direction of the gradient, and that way we are hoping to increase the loss. All right, let's see this attack in action. We load a pre-trained ResNet using torch vision. We set it to evaluation mode because it has multiple batch normalization layers and they behave differently at training time and at inference time. We use our utility function readImage. And here we run our attack. And the only thing left to do here is to visualize how the image looked like before and after the attack. We turn the tensors into arrays so that we can visualize them with matplotlib, and we also create this difference array that is supposed to highlight where exactly the biggest changes are. Finally, we format the plot a little bit and then save it into an image. As you can see, in each iteration, the loss was going up. And after 16 iterations, we were able to fool the network. Also note that we are getting this warning because our clamping was not that strict. As you can see, the original image is clearly a lion, and that is exactly what the network predicted. Note that I actually added the classes corresponding to the label IDs. When it comes to the modified image, the network thinks it's a golden retriever. The difference between the original and the modified image is really subtle. It is the color of the sky that is slightly different. Anyway, I find it impressive that we were able to fool the network with such a simple algorithm. The second example is going to demonstrate the integrated gradients method. It was introduced in this paper called Axiomatic Attribution for Deep Networks, written by Mukund Sundararajan and other authors in 2017. Again, I'm going to leave out all the details and just focus on the essentials. The integrated gradients is a simple algorithm that allows us to determine how much different input features contribute to the final prediction. Instead of just using a single gradient with respect to the inputs, they propose to generate a straight line path between a baseline input and our actual input. For example, if our inputs are images, the baseline could be an image that is entirely black. Anyway, once we have this path, we collect multiple gradients along it and then aggregate them by the following formula. Here we can see visually how the algorithm performs compared to the simple gradient approach. It seems to be way better. All right, let us create a script called explain.py. The goal of this function is to run the forward pass and then to extract the logit corresponding to the target. Now we can implement the function that computes the integrated gradients. The first argument is the input image. Baseline is the other image as discussed in the paper. This is going to be a classifier network. Finally, target is going to be the ground truth label ID. The number of steps will determine the number of tensors along the line from the baseline to the input image. This function returns two different tensors of the same shape. The first one is going to represent the integrated gradients, and the second one is going to be the gradient with respect to the input image. This path list is going to hold all the tensors on the straight line from the baseline all the way to the input image. Note that the last element of this list is going to be the input image itself. Here we are computing the gradient with respect to all the tensors that are lying on the line. This line approximates the integral proposed in the paper. And finally, we return the integrated gradients and also the gradient with respect to inputs. Let us now see whether it works. As in the previous example, we load the pre-trained ResNet and set it to the evaluation mode. We load our image and then also convert it to an array. Here we prepare the inputs for the compute integrated gradients function. Know that this baseline image should be very close to just a black image. The reason why we construct it like this is because the ResNet already assumes that the input is normalized. Here I call our function, and I also hardcode the target label to be 291, corresponding to a lion. Now the only thing left to do is visualization. As you can see, I'm using the scale grad function that we wrote at the very beginning of this tutorial. I take these scale gradients and I multiply the input image with them. This way, we will have an idea what parts of the image are explained by the algorithm and which aren't. Right, so now we should be ready to run it. Here you can see the results. The first two images represent the baseline and the input respectively. The third image shows how the single gradient with respect to the input explains where the network is looking. The brighter the pixel, the more relevant that given pixel is for predicting the line class. Even though it is really noisy, we clearly see that the face and the mane of the lion are something the network focuses on. Finally, if we look at the rightmost image, it shows the integrated gradients approach. It has less noise than the other approach, and one can clearly see that the face of the lion is the most important part of the image. Before I finish this video, let me just show you two really amazing open source projects that are focused on the two subjects that I discussed today. The first one is named Foolbox. It is focused on adversarial examples, and it implements a lot of different algorithms, and some of them don't even require access to gradients. The second project is called Captain, and it is focused on interpreting of predictions of neural networks. It is closely linked to PyTorch, and it has an amazing API and a wide range of implemented algorithms. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, do not forget to like it. And if you would like to get similar content in the future, do not hesitate to subscribe. See you next time.